Okay, so I've just been informed that somehow we have not covered glyphosates and Hashimoto's. And I'm not sure that's 100% correct because it is on my list of the, well, when I gave the list, it was 39 different triggers of Hashimoto's. Now it's like 42, but it is on that list. And so most of you know glyphosates as all the bad chemicals that are on our vegetables and our fruits that are being sprayed on there. Most of you would probably know it as Monsanto, and you would know it as other companies that make these chemicals. You would know it as Roundup, but all these chemicals, they're glyphosates, and they're bad. They're toxic. They're poisonous. There have been numerous studies that they are negative factors for human existence, for human physiology. But it is listed as a specific trigger for autoimmune thyroid disease. And when I say that, if you look at our presentation on the triggers for Hashimoto's, you'll find that there's at that point in time, there's like 39 of them. Every one of those triggers is on that list because they have been thoroughly researched, either in credible labs around the world, and even more so through what's called meta-analysis of research. So what that means is they studied the people who study these topics of how chemicals affect human physiology, and also of how they affect tissue specifically. The group that studied whether glyphosates affect Hashimoto's did mostly meta-analysis. And here's what that means. It means that they looked at every single study that was ever done on glyphosates, and then every single study that was ever done on glyphosates and thyroid tissue. And that means that there was positive studies, that means that there were neutral studies, that means that there were studies that said no, there was no thing. And when they looked at the meta-analysis, they were reviewing millions of people. Essentially, by the time they looked at all these research projects, and this research project was 30 people, and this one was 700, and this one was 4,000, and so on and so forth, it was quite a bit of research. That's a meta-analysis. You look at all the good, the neutral, the bad, and then you put it together, and then you come up with a conclusion. And what came out of there was that a number of the studies showed that if you expose yourself to glyphosates, then you are you will raise if you have an established, confirmed high antibody count for Hashimoto's. So your thyroid peroxidase enzyme antibody, let's say they're 300. That exposure to glyphosates will raise those antibodies upon exposure by up to 70%, by up to 70%, and then you'll get that, and you could get a flare, and then then they'll drop back down. And so every one of these triggers on that 39 different triggers for Hashimoto's presentation shows that they raise antibodies to different degrees, some 25%, some 50%, some 75%. So the glyphosates are up there. This is where the big controversy over do I eat organic, do I not eat organic? Yeah, it's probably better to eat organic, but if you're autoimmune and you can afford it, it's definitely better to eat organic, without a doubt. And so if you have autoimmune thyroid disease, glyphosates are definitely a trigger. They're definitely a factor. Because you're exposing yourself to them every day, and you can't afford to maybe go full-blown organic, especially in this day and age of increasing inflation rates and higher costs at the supermarket and so on and so forth, then you want to expose yourself to some sort of a kind of gentle detox, maybe. Like some, there's a ton of things out there. One of the most common ones I'll just mention is like some sort of a milk thistle or something like that. I would take something like that every day. It's a little bit more than peeing on a forest fire, but as far as doing that, but if you do it on a regular basis, it'll dampen the chemical load. Glutathione's another good thing to take for that. Probably those two things together, something for your liver, something for like glutathione pathways. And I take them every day. I take the glutathione every day, like my life depended on it. I take another product that I won't mention because it's a product, but it has milk thistle in it and a bunch of other things. So that's glyphosates. Yes, they're definitely a trigger. And you should strive to either stay away from them, or if you can't stay away from them, you should strive to support your liver in trying to get rid of all of that stuff by using something that supports your liver to increase detoxing you of chemical sensitivities.